by-elections are meant to replace opposition MDC lawmakers. The 21 legislators left the party and forfeited their seats in parliament. And the MDC and several splinter groups have decided to boycott the polls.
Election day has been characterized by low voter turnout, something people here put down to the lack of credible opposition to the ruling party, which is widely tipped to sweep all the seats.
Now that's despite several candidates from new opposition parties.
Zimbabwe is still very much a two-party political system in which we have the two dominant political parties, ZANU-PF and the MDC led by Morgan Tsvangirai. So if these by-elections were to be of any interest in terms of political, serious political contest, then we needed to see the two political parties in the field.
With the MDC out of the race, it's likely the ruling party will win Harare and Bulawayo, the country's two main urban centers. The ruling party's toughest challenge comes in the form of Themba Mliswa. Once a senior member of ZANU-PF, he was expelled for having links with ousted former Vice President Joyce Mujuru.
I don't think we even have to discuss about winning. Winning is already a done deal. It's by how much.
He may sound confident, but Mliswa had tried to have the elections postponed.
He was desperate. He went to court at the last minute, trying to stop the elections. That shows you the level of desperation that he has. ZANU-PF has wrapped up the campaigns in that constituency. It's always been a ZANU-PF constituency. And so ZANU-PF will win. The challenge with individuals is they think they're bigger than the party. Yet the party is bigger than individuals. It is a collective.
The final results of these by-elections are expected Friday. Farai Mwakutuya, CCTV, Harare, Zimbabwe.